Hi, Roscoe here. It's going to be more kind of fun battles than anything else. Using the team Calf Arse. Using the Sea Calf. They've been having quite a lot of fun with recently. It's not a super strong pet, but it's quite fun. The Jamie's Dancer. Because the Sea Calf's quite weak, I'm using a Surge with it. I'm going to buff that damage with Acid Rain, the Cleansing Rain buff for that 25% more damage. I mean, really, on this, I could go with the PB. They're quite expensive for what they are, these Sea Calves, so I haven't bothered. It's not too much difference in them. And then I've been wanting to play this game for a while, or this pet for a while. So I finally used him. I played one game with him, and I beat a really strong team of a Terraclaw, Bone Serpent, and Zufu. It was really close actually at the end. Because the Bone Serpent had the Bone Barrage, and it kind of negated the bubble to an extent against the Zufu. Otherwise, it would have been a lot more straightforward. But let's see. I mean, the cues are pretty much instant whilst it's on the pet tournament. There's kind of hope that I don't face anything too difficult. Cool. I'm gonna. Yeah, I'm going to start my Sea Calf. I can kind of use the bubble here. Eat its cooldowns. I haven't really got a good camp pet for this idol. And he is still just hitting into the bubble there. Okay. That's 2 at 40%. That's like super lucky. Let's hope that I don't get a stun here. Come on. Yeah, let's go with this. I cannot believe this person's luck. Okay, let's get my bubble up. Cool, I'm going to stay in. Sort of one charge on the bubble. I'm going to feed here. I'm going to bring in my hatchling. Let's slow him down. Let's get this debuff up as well now. Should hopefully take him out here. And this hatching is going to hit super hard against the Valk. Cool. Yeah, I mean, I don't think that this this team is kind of like a top team at all. I think it's a team that you can probably get away with in this tournament. Yeah, I've wanted to use a hatching for a while because it just hits so hard. And it did there. It certainly kind of adds power to the rest of this kind of team. Jamie's Dancer hits relatively hard as well, so. But yeah, that Seacuff with its kind of bubble and feed and things, it's kind of a fairly tanky, healy pet. It's quite a defensive pet. Let's hope that I mean, if I get some strong teams. Okay. This ankle render could cause me some problems. Okay. I don't want to run the risk of like a headbutt or anything like that. It's gonna hit really quite hard. But then, so is this. I'm gonna swap this pet in. Could swap out here because, yeah. Should go for some damage. Wow, that crit, super lucky. He's probably gonna kill me here. I think I do just want to get the kind of the, I say guaranteed kill. I need to hit high. Oh, that sucks. It's never fairy dragon. It's really kind of taking me to the cleaners. It's probably going to kill this as well, actually. And it's that big crit on the hatchling that's really cost me. At least this heal will be fairly large. Unfortunately, I don't think the sea calf has quite got it in it to. Okay, so let's go for damage. He's gonna probably try and go the acidic goo dive again. At least he is now within kill range of my feed. Now, unfortunately, I have no cooldowns for this ankle vendor. So all it's going to be is like a black claw, and then it's just going to need to be a hunting party. Unfortunately, this is GG for the sea calf. I think it was the crit from that Never Fairy Dragon enabled it to proc the racial, so it caused me to lose out on actually being able to kill it. Kind of sucks. Very kind of an RNG kind of loss. Possibly could have bought in my sea calf, bubbled, and then if he'd gone for the life exchange, I wouldn't have been quite so penalised. Then again, perhaps a high hit could have saved me. I mean, I'm probably not going to get the replay because there's so many people in the queue. I'm going to start with the sea calf just in case they go with that iron starlet. I'm going to have to kind of hope that they don't powerball. As long as I'm quicker, it kind of means that I can preempt the wind up there, my bubble. He's literally just going for them now. I think it's worth me doing that. Oh wow. He did have the charge. Should not have brought that pet in. It's definitely a mistake. That was 100% a mistake. Poor guy. I did almost wonder if that was the right call going for the rain dance, but seeing that, seeing that shard of Cyrumph, I don't know how you say its name, just disappear. Poor guy. Must have been a high end crit with the kind of all the buffs and stuff. So your calf ass is doing actually okay. As I said though, it's not exactly kind of the true meta. It's kind of the fun meta. Well, I do get to kind of play silly teams. What's that? Get bombling. Oh, cool. And the kind of the good thing with the keys at the moment is you generally don't meet the same player twice. Ah, oh, that's gonna suck. Flyer. This, I don't like facing this pet. Come on for some crits. I do think this is a really strong pet. Do I want to save this guy? Yeah, probably. So I'm probably gonna avoid the ice too. I can't, that double hits. Because he's going to change the weather back. Don't think I'm going to win this one, unfortunately. End of this guy, and then the sea calf's not got it in him to take out this whole team, unfortunately. I suppose Bruins does buff that. Yeah, I did not know that double hit actually double hits through the bubble. What he needs to do now is swing in that pedal feet, and it's GG for him. Essentially, I'm just delaying the inevitable, essentially, here. But yeah, that's a strong pet. That team isn't a strong team. Just does counter mine really well. But that's the thing, you can just run fun teams. Like an undead would just undo that team massively. Bone Serpent has the potential to carry this whole team. He's a slow Bone Serpent, though. Let's start with this. I'm gonna bubble just in case whatever he runs actually. This could bring a swap to the Bone Serpent. Yeah, so it's kind of wasted that cooldown. Because I've not. This pet isn't that good against him. So let's get some damage down. So we're going to use his heal here. Now I've got a couple of buffed attacks. That's a poor choice. Oh wow, I got the stun off. So whilst I can, I'm gonna get my heal from this Bone Serpent. I'll bubble the lift off. Because it's a HH, he's gonna really kind of get shredded by this now. Yeah, it wasn't running optimally, and it's kind of. I mean, I want that HH brooding, actually, I want that HH crystalline brooding, it's quite a cool version. So, one more win with. Half arsed. Yeah, I don't know whether YouTube will let me put that on the title, so I might just put sea calf. Because like in the UK anyway, like I don't even know if, like how that's spelled. It's actually a word or not. There's like an R. Spelt differently here. Because that means like a donkey over here. Strong pet. Yeah, it can be strong. So let's start. The Seagull. Cool that he'll be going for that. Cool darkness. I hope. Couple of three hits. He won't be going for the Nocturnal Strike. Now when he does come on 40%, I cool. Really, really, really glad I made that switch. Not quite so glad about that miss. I need to hit here. Yeah, that miss was very unfortunate. I wonder if he can get a miss. No. Unless he gets really lucky. No, he's not. Not risked it. I'm going to go for the lucky hit. That was really quite lucky. So I want to heal here whilst I'm kind of not reduced in my damage. Then this next hit will be the one. And then the sea calf, you've got me there. Got me to 5 wins. Yeah, just any kind of bubble ability is good. It's got the priority move. Is it a defensive pet that the sea calf? Definitely. You can definitely get away with it in the tournament. I do kind of think that first loss was kind of very RNG. Feel like kind of the opponent probably got away with one there with that crit on my Raptor. Did well as well. Faced too much, that gave it too much trouble. There was that one team of humanoids that kind of did really well against this. I didn't realise those double hits would break the bubble. I know now. Yeah, cool. Well, thank you for watching. She's using the sea calf. It's one of the pets that is eligible for the tournament we've got in EU, which is kind of why I've been playing it and why I decided to use it. It's probably the spec and the kind of the talent or ability choices I'll use. And yeah, maybe PB would be better. But it's they're quite dear, that's the only thing. They're quite expensive to buy. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll look to see you in the next video.